的朋友学会了怎么样用搅打的方法来做 butter cake， 就是牛油蛋糕之后，现在我们来做一个比较难度比较高一点点的印尼千层蛋糕。So ladies and gentlemen, once you have mastered how to make butter cake, now we can go on to a more complicating cake. That is the Indonesian layer cake.我相信很多人都很喜欢吃这个印尼千层蛋糕，就是做起来就是这个样子的。So this is Indonesian layer cake, layer by layer you have to make. It is a very delicious cake, it is very expensive, and now you can make it at home. 你发现这个印尼千层蛋糕是比较贵的，因为它工多嘛，所以今天教你们怎么样做这个印尼千层蛋糕，那么你就可以在家里过来吃了。好，做这个印尼千层蛋糕，首先呢，我们就要准备，蛋白跟蛋黄，先跟它分开来。To make this cake, first of all, you have to separate 15 eggs. We need 15 eggs. All in all, 15 eggs, 15粒蛋。我们要把它蛋白跟蛋黄分开来。蛋黄要15粒，蛋白只要5粒。We need to have 15 egg yolks and only 5 egg whites. So over here, I'm going to remove 5 eggs.Egg whites， 把这个蛋黄可以放在这里哦，蛋白呢，我们就放在这里。那么你们一定会说，哇，这么多蛋黄的蛋糕，那么它胆固醇不是很高吗？那么你们可以放心，如果你们是用健康的鸡蛋，好像 Omega Eggs 那个 Omega Plus Egg， 那么你就可以放心，因为它是属于很健康的一个鸡蛋。它的胆固醇就比较低哦，所以你可以很放心的用 Omega Plus 的鸡蛋来做这个蛋糕了。好，现在我们把这蛋白先放起来。这边有15粒的蛋黄，那分的时候呢很小心，就是你的蛋黄一点呢都不好跌在这蛋白里面。Be careful when you separate the egg whites from the egg yolk. If your eggs are very very fresh.Then you don't have to worry. Especially today, I'm using Omega Plus egg. It is a very healthy egg. You don't have to worry about the cholesterol. If the eggs are fresh, it is very firm. So you find that the egg yolk will not break up easily. And now we are going to put in the egg white and we are going to whisk until it is very stiff. 那现在呢，我们就先把蛋白放在我们的打蛋器里面，要先跟它来打，打到它很硬。那打的时候呢，尽量就是用快的速度来打。Use high speed to beat your egg white. Yes, while waiting for the egg whites to be beaten up, you have to get ready your oven. 现在我们可以把我们的烤炉先准备好。那现在我们要用到的呢，就是220度 Celsius. We need to use 220 degrees Celsius, and you're going to use.Upper and lower， 用上下火，先跟它拿来烤制哦。现在烤制15分钟。好，现在大家来看一看我们的蛋白，这蛋白已经够硬了。那大家请看，这蛋白呢就已经非常的硬了。You can see that the egg white has been beaten until it's very stiff. So now you can turn off the speed and you take it out.那大家请看哦，这蛋白呢要打到它这样，非常非常的硬哦 ，it's very very stiff， and now you're going to take it out。先把已经打硬了的蛋白先跟它拿出来。那在这里呢，我们现在呢就可以。把这个盆子呢，跟它拿一抹一抹 ，just use a piece of paper just to clean up the bowl because it's clean。大家请看哈、哦，它是干净的。那现在呢，我们就会加入我们的牛油了。We need to have 450 grams of butter. You cannot use any butter that you like. You have to use the tin butter. 我们要用到的就是这个罐装的牛油。为什么要用罐装的牛油呢？就是因为这个牛油它没有水分 ，it doesn't contain any water, no liquid inside. So after baking, it is very nice. And now you can put in your butter, 把这个牛油放在这里。 450 gram， 然后我们要用到的就是270 gram 的糖粉 ，and you also need to use 270 grams of icing sugar. So icing sugar, please sieve it before you put it in. 把这个糖粉呢，先看它来吸过。Okay. Now you can put in your sugar. 把这个糖粉呢，一定要吸过，因为糖粉有时候会一粒一粒的哦。好，所以现在呢，才把吸过好了的糖粉呢，加在我们的牛油里面。Now you can beat it up. Use creamy method like just now. 那首先呢，我们就是好像刚才一样哈，用那个 creaming method， 把这个牛油跟糖先跟它来打。现在呢，就是用这个，用中度，中的速度 ，use medium speed to beat up to cream the butter and the icing sugar. And over here, you can prepare your egg yolk. 在这里呢，我们要准备的就是刚才15粒的鸡蛋黄 ，15 egg yolk. You add in 1 tablespoon of brandy.If you can use brandy, you eat brandy. If you cannot, you can just omit it. 这个白兰地酒呢是给它比较香哈、哦，不要加的话呢也不要紧。那现在你还可以加入的就是1/4 小匙的 vanilla essence. Now you add in 3/4 teaspoon of vanilla essence. Three ingredients, you just beat it up. 然后我们就是用一个打蛋器哈、哦，用手轻轻的跟它拿来搅拌均匀。好，再跟它打。打了以后，现在我们来看看我们的牛油。Now look at the butter mixture。我们这里还要用到的呢，就是一大匙半的甜牛奶 ，that is the sweet condensed milk。And when you find that everything is combined, now you can add in your sweet condensed milk. That is 1.5 tablespoons of sweet condensed milk。把它搅拌的非常非常均匀了以后，好，大家现在请看一下哈、哦，刚才我们已经。打好了的鸡蛋黄，还有我们已经打好了的鸡蛋白，然后还要准备的呢，就是今天要用到的面粉了。那今天的用到的面粉呢，就是135 gram 的普通面粉。This is 135 grams of ordinary flour. And now you have to sift the flour. 现在呢，我们也是要把我们的面粉呢拿来吸过，然后我们要用到的就是2小匙半的混合香料 ，This is 2.5 teaspoon of mixed spices. For making Indonesian layer cake, you have to add in this special mixed spices to give you the special taste. 好，现在我们在这里呢，就跟它拿来吸过。好，那这面粉呢就已经吸好了，它就有了很香很香的那个。千层糕的香味。好，现在大家来看一看哈、哦。首先呢，我们可以把刚才已经打好了的鸡蛋黄呢，跟它慢慢的倒进去。如果你没有这个机器的话，那么你就是要用手来打了哈、哦，用手慢慢的跟它打下去。或如果你有这个机器的话呢，你可以这样慢慢慢慢的跟它搅下去。等它搅拌到非常均匀了以后，现在呢，我们可以用最慢的度数把这个面粉呢也加下去。And now we can add in the sift flour. Use low speed, very low speed, to mix in the flour. 那最后呢，我们就可以加入我们的蛋白了。那加入蛋白的时候呢，你可以这样，先把一半的先放下去。Now you can add in your egg white. When you want to put in your egg white mixture.It will be better if you mixed up a little bit with the batter first. 就是这个样子哈、哦。我们先把刚才已经打好了的那个面团呢，拿一点出来先。Take out some, 然后先在这里呢，跟他把那个蛋黄，跟他把那个蛋白呢，先跟他搅拌均匀。So, ladies and gentlemen, because the egg white is very stiff, so it would be better if you can add in a little bit of the mixture, the cake mixture, with the egg white first. You mix it up like this. 先跟它拿来搅一搅。 then you find that the egg white is not so stiff already. 这蛋白没有这么硬了，那么我们才把它倒回去。 Then only you put it in. Then you find that your cake egg white will be very easy to mix it in. 那么等一下你会发现到呢，你要搅这个蛋白的时候就非常的容易了。所以做什么东西呢，都有它的方法哦。那么现在我们加下去，用最慢最慢的度数 ，use low speed to mix it in. 好，现在呢，我们就可以把这个 machine 呢，给它关掉 ，just take it out。 And we are going to use your hand, use hand to stir it a little bit more. 然后就是用我们的手轻轻的跟它拿来搅拌到非常非常的均匀。So scrape down the side, and the texture is like this. 看到吗？它就好像 butter cake 的 mixture 一样。好，现在呢，我们要准备的呢是一个盆。 Now we have to get ready a baking tin. 这个就是今天要准备的盆。刚才的第一个蛋糕我是用圆的，然后我教你们怎么样用它的边，它的底跟它的边来跟它围住。当你用一个四方形的时候，你就不需要，你只是要准备一张纸哈，就是这样。先跟它拿来这 ，just get ready a piece of paper, fold it according to the height of the tin, and then you put it in. And when you find that it fits, then this is what you have to do. You just have to use a piece of paper, use a pair of scissors, and then you snip. 就是在这里，看它剪到它的边，在这里， just cut to the edge. Then it will put in like this. You find that this piece of paper is not big enough, then what you can do is you can use another piece to join it up. 如果你的纸不够的话，你可以用另外一张纸呢跟它接下去。好，现在呢我们就可以用一点点的油， just use a bit of oil. ，跟它油一油它的边。 直到等一下呢，它能够很容易的粘在上面。再一次的跟它擦多一点油 ，brush with a bit of oil so that it will stick well. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is how you prepare your cake tin. Just use a big piece of paper, fold up the edge, and then you snip at the side. Then you can fix it in, brush with a bit of oil. 这就是怎么样准备一个四方形的盆子，用一张大张的纸折起来，围它的边。好，现在呢擦了油以后，我们就可以放我们的第一层了。 Now we can put in the first layer. You know this Indonesian layer cake? You have to bake it layer by layer. 我们是一层一层来烤的。那烤的时候呢，就是放一层下去，烤到它黄了的时候，我们再放一层。所以那个你看到那个比较黄色的地方呢，就是已经烤好了的面。So you put it one layer by one layer. The brown layer is the top layer after baking. So to do it, this is what you have to do. It is better for you to get ready a cup. 好，现在我们准备一个量杯哈。 你要什么杯都可以，大的小的，要你自己喜欢。看你的盆是几大。那么我用这个杯来放呢，就是说每一次你都是用同一个杯，那么你做出来的层呢，就不会说有一些比较厚，有一些比较薄。So this is a cup that I'm going to use to put in my cake mixture. You use the same cup for every layer, then you get the same level. Right. Now I'm going to fill it in. 现在呢，就是把这个料放下去。 就是这样哈，one cup. Now I'm going to put it in. 现在呢，我就是把一整杯的料呢，跟它放进去。Then you level it. 然后就是轻轻的跟它做成一层。 如果你要它这个千层蛋糕看起来比较多层的话，那么你就可以做比较小的盆子。When your tin is small, then you get more layers. If your tin is big, then you get less layers. 就是这个样子哦。那么你不要放得太厚，如果你放得太厚的话嘛，等一下做出来的 Indonesian layer cake 呢，就会一层一层看起来比较粗，没有这样又细哦。So ladies and gentlemen, it is very important to note that the layer by layer, it shouldn't be too thick. If it's too thick, then it's not nice. It doesn't look fine. Just one cup like this, and you find that it'd be just nice to get one thin layer. 那好了，那这就是我们的第一层，看起来是非常的薄的。Can you see? It's very thin. The layer is very thin. And now we can put it to bake.现在呢，我们就可以放在红炉里面去烤了。第一层是用上下火 ，for the first layer you have to use top and bottom fire. Then after that we are going to change. We 们用220度的火给它烤，烤到差不多是5分钟，它的上面下面都黄了。那个时候呢，我们就是改用上火 ，we don't use bottom fire after the first layer because.If you keep on using top and bottom layer, then the bottom layer will get burned, right? So you are only going to use a top layer. Just brown the top layer, brown the top layer to get layer by layer. So you can imagine how time consuming it is. 那一般上呢，我们如果你要节省时间的话，你要节省时间的话，你可以用两个盆。I always tell my students, if you want to be fast or you don't want to waste time.What you can do is, you can get ready two smaller cake tins. So you put one layer, put it to bake. Then you prepare another tin. By the time you spread everything ready, then you put in the tin. You take out the other tin, you put in this tin. So then you put in another layer. So you don't have to waste time like this, standing here looking at your friends before you put in the next layer. 所以你看，这样就会比较快很多啦。用两个盆。我第一个盆子放下去烤的时候，我就准备第二个盆子。等到我第二个盆子铺好的时候，那个第一层就已经好了。你拿出来，那这个就放上去，那么你就不用浪费时间在这边等。好，因为今天是做示范哦 ，just to show you how to make. So I'm waiting for the cake to be brown before I put in the next layer. Next layer, you have to get ready. This is something that is very flat. This is to press it.Just in case there's air bubble inside, you're going to use this to press it. And you're going to use a skewer, or you can just use a toothpick to prick whatever air bubbles on top. 等一下呢，我们要用到呢一支牙签，还有就是一个跟它压平的东西。那经过了5分钟以后呢，它应该就是黄了。我们可以来看一看先哈。Just check after 5 minutes to see whether it is brown enough.It should be all brown, okay? Now over here, 看到吗 ？Now you can see, if you find any bubble on top, you can use your toothpick to prick it up. 那如果看到哈，哪里有那个不平的地方呢？我们就是用我们的这个牙签跟它拿来压一压。那然后呢，我们可以在上面哦，在上面这笔。一点点哦，只是烧上一点点的油 ，just brush with a little bit of melted butter, just a little bit only, not too much, so that it won't be so dry. Then you can use this to press it. Just use this to press it to level, so that afterwards you find that every layer is very level. And then you are going to pour in the second layer. 然后在这里呢，我们现在呢就要倒入我们的第二层了。把第二层放上去以后，又是一样哈、哦，跟它拿来弄到它很平，然后又放去烤。那如果你有这个 scraper 的话哈、哦、，ladies and gentlemen, if you have a scraper like this, that is very level. 如果你有一个这样的 scraper 的话，那么比做工就会比较容易哈、哦。你就是这样轻轻的跟它拉一拉，跟它拉一拉。它就比较平，那么 我们的另外一层呢又准备好了。Then we've got ready the second layer. 是一层薄薄的。那现在呢我们就可以把它放下去烤了。Now you put into bake, but for this layer, you have to change it to only the top layer, only the top fire.现在我们是只是用上火来烤，不要再用下火了。如果下火又再烤的话，那么下面那层就焦了哈。只是烤上火给它黄，就是这样一层一层的在里面烤，烤到全部用完为止。So you are going to use the same way, only using the top fire to bake layer by layer, layer by layer, until you 蒙安多呀。Then you just finish until the final layer, then you use top and bottom fire again. 一直来到最后的一层的时候，我们又再用上下火来烤。
各位朋友，这就是已经烤好了的印尼千层蛋糕。So this is the baked Indonesian kueh lapis or layer cake.
好，各位朋友，那经过了两个小时以后呢，你这个印尼的千层蛋糕已经冷了，就可以切出来。它的样子就是这样的。 So you see, after 2 hours, you see that the cake is already completely cold. Then you can take it out and cut it into pieces like this. And this Indonesian layer cake can keep for a long time. 如果你把它放在冰橱里面的话，一个月它都不会坏哦。 You see, the Indonesian layer cake can keep it for 1 month. Just keep it in the fridge. Anytime you want, you just take out a few pieces and you eat.